The townhouse was quiet. Sometimes this was how Dibbs liked it best, with no one in residence. What would that be like, he wondered, being tucked away here in London with a family of his own for the holidays? He saw lovely yet sorrowful deep brown eyes and light chestnut hair in a simple plait coiled on top of her head. He would either hate himself for turning her away or hate himself for not doing so. Mrs. Her gaze returned to his, filled with hope. Miss Ashman, sir. She pulled the cloak back from where she clutched it so closely, revealing a scrawny and quite miserable-looking black kitten that meowed loudly in protest at the sleet. Come in. She reminded him of the does that wandered the Kellington meadows. Shy, easily spooked, and ready to run at the slightest hint of danger. Grace couldn't believe her luck. After a week of living off scraps, being turned from doorways of what she had formerly thought of as friends, being chased and harassed, she might finally be warm again. hope was a thing that couldn't really be killed, it seemed. Tall, austere, in just his shirt sleeves and blue waistcoat, he managed to look better dressed than many men of her acquaintance. His hair was dark, pulled back in a tidy queue. And his eyes. Sweet heavens, his eyes were the color of a cloudless summer day. Sit, please. Perhaps they were safe. Perhaps. He hadn't foreseen that by removing her cloak, he revealed how much her wet dress clung to her. Thank you, Mr. Dibbs. Thank you, Mr. Dibbs. Just Dibbs.